Hello and welcome to this joint production of NewsClick and the Indian Writers Forum. Today we have with us Megha Pansare. She's a professor of Russian as well as the daughter-in-law of Govind Pansare. Thank you very much, Megha ji, for coming here. As you already know that we are doing this interview after we've heard of Gauri Lankesh's murder. And today we'll be discussing some of the, what we think or presume to be some of the links between the murders of rationalists, Dabholkar, Kalburgi and Pansare, and now Gauri Lankesh. Thank you very much, ma'am, for giving time to us. There has been some kind of evidence that links these murders to the Sanatan Sanstha. I'm referring to an Indian Express report which said that the police have found that the same kind of revolver has been used for Gauri Lankesh's murder also, the same kind that was used earlier for Kalburgi, for instance. Can you tell us, can you walk us through some of these earlier cases also where these kinds of murders have happened?
As far as Dr. Dabholkar, Comrade Pansare and Professor Kalburgi's assassination cases are concerned, Gujarat Forensic Laboratory has given one report actually. The cartridges and bullets which were found in these three cases, they were sent to the Gujarat Forensic Laboratory for assassination. And it was found that two weapons were used in Comrade Pansare's assassination. Out of these two, one was used in Dr. Dabholkar's case and another one was used in Professor Kalburgi's case. That is what has been mentioned in the Sessions Court at some level. So I feel that it is very clear that there is a strong link between these three cases. It has been mentioned in the court also. But recently, one more assassination has taken place and it was really shocking, Gauri Lankesh's assassination in Bangalore. I remember her when I met her last time, that is on 26th August. We were supposed to meet the Chief Minister of Karnataka and we had taken time there. And Professor Devi, myself, we went and saw the Chief Minister. We were there to demand a public statement from the government and accordingly some action, because during these 2 years nothing has been done in this case. So Gauri Lankesh was also supposed to be there, but she was somewhat late. So when we came out of the residence of the Chief Minister, at the gate we met Gauri Lankesh and we had a conversation with her for half an hour or more. And we discussed these Professor Kalburgi's issue, how these three cases are interconnected. And I also told her that there is a totally lack of coordination between these investigations. So we discussed the cases. The focus was on Professor Kalburgi's case as 30th August was approaching and we were organizing a protest on that day. So while departing, we said that we are to meet soon because we want to plan some next protests also. And then we departed. So I feel it's so painful for me that we lost her in such a brutal manner. She was finished. So now when I remember her and I see the news coming, the information coming, we feel that there are many factors which we can link with the previous cases. For example, the modus operandi is the same. That is one thing. Another thing that I see is the personalities who were killed before, they were constantly attacking, they were constantly talking about the rightist people. They were against superstition. They were doing a lot of things, delivering lectures, conducting workshops, delivering public meetings, and everywhere they used to present their rationalist approach. As far as Gauri Lankesh's case is concerned, she was also attacking the right-wing people, the Hinduist people. She was speaking and writing about the atmosphere of intolerance that has been created during all these 2-3 years, and the killings taking place in different parts of the country in the name of religion. So these factors, they connect these personalities together. That is what I feel. But the investigation is in progress. Even at the case, Comrade Pansare's case, the investigation agencies said that there could be any reason, and so we are investigating in different angles. So when we were insisting on the right wing, they should investigate the right wing forces, the investigation agency said that no, we will give 50% coverage to this, and there may be other reasons also. So we are looking for that, we are searching for that also. But after some months, I think 8 to 10 months, when the first arrest was made, at that time it was clear that the people who were involved in the conspiracy, because they told that it's a deep-rooted conspiracy, all those, they were associated with a right-wing organization, that is Sanatan Sanstha, which is based in Goa.
In fact, one of the reasons that has been given, and this is a statement by the Sanatan Sanstha spokesperson, Chetan Rajans, and he has in fact said that there is actually no evidence to link Gauri Lankesh's murder with their organization. But I think that this was a statement made even when the earlier previous murders took place. And the police also did not, in fact, as you mentioned, focus in on the right-wing, Hindu right-wing organizations. Do you think this is a repetition of the entire process that you have been going through for 2 years?
Yeah, as I remember, Sanatan Sanstha has never denied that the suspects, they are associated with Sanatan Sanstha. They have never denied this fact. They have provided legal support to all the accused in this case. Thirdly, two persons who are absconding since 2009, that is Saranga Kolkar and Vinay Pawar. So they were also associated with Madgaon bomb blast case in 2009. So since then they have been absconding. Till now they have not rejected that they are our sadhaks. Regarding this statement, I can say that this is the initial phase of this matter, and maybe this statement is given. I think after some time, when the picture will be clear and there will be evidences, everything will be clear.
There seems to be, as you had mentioned, there's some kind of ideological fight also with respect to the three killings prior to this and now Gauri Lankesh. There seems to be a very clear-cut ideological battle there. Could you tell us why do you think this could be also labeled as an ideological battle, not some kind of personal feud or other reasons that have cropped up suddenly?
This point has been discussed in the High Court also. You know, when there is some personal rivalry or there are assassinations due to some personal reasons, then the evidence you get very clear, very easily. Means the police tries to investigate and find comes to some conclusion very easily. Here in these cases, in all the previous cases, it has become quite clear that these assassinations have taken place because of the ideological differences, not accepting their thoughts, not accepting their way of communicating their rationalism, their rational thoughts to common people, and that too very effectively. Means Dr. Dabholkar was a very good organizer. He went to the grassroots. And in many villages in Maharashtra, he had formed the branches of Andhrashraddha Nirmulan Samiti. Comrade Pansare was constantly traveling, and he had a very good rapport with common people. Means he used to go to any platform he was invited, and he used to speak on these matters. So Professor Kalburgi, on another way, he was a researcher, and he used to write whatever he felt. So all these people, they did receive threats, but they did not give up. That was their great thing. So here in the court it was discussed that these three assassinations were not at all due to any personal reason, not because of family dispute, not because of property matters or nothing else. So these three assassinations were well planned. There was a deep-rooted conspiracy. I think the decision to attack them was done long before, and then very systematically it was carried, the plan was carried out. So ideological battle has become very clear. In Gauri Lankesh's case, she was not just a common journalist, but she was a thinker also. She had her own ideology. So I think that ideological factors do matter in these cases. And nowadays, this pattern in the previous cases that we see, that if you don't want to accept the other's ideology, and in democratic way, if you can't accept the right of these people to express their views openly, then they are going to attack these people. So this pattern continues. That is what I feel.
Absolutely. We definitely see Gauri Lankesh's murder as part of a continued series of murders and a different pattern that you have mentioned. Finally, I'd like to, and this is especially relevant because of this anecdote that you gave, that you actually met her while you were thinking what could be the way forward for the three previous murders. This is a tweet that she gave on September 5th, 2017. And she says, "Why do I feel that some of us are fighting amongst ourselves? We all know our biggest enemy. Can we all please concentrate on that?" Ma'am, I would like to know what do you think is the way forward? Because we cannot be bogged down by this. We still have to continue our fight even in grief.
The last meeting, as I mentioned, of Gauri Lankesh. So in Comrade Pansare's case also the same thing happened. I still remember there is a collector office in Kolhapur, and on the footpath we always sit there for protest. So we were sitting on the footpath and protesting against Dr. Dabholkar's assassination. We were demanding justice, we were demanding speedy investigation in that case. Comrade Pansare was with there, we were sitting together holding placards in our hands, and the next time we were protesting for his justice. So these things are happening and they are very shocking for me. Secondly, as you said, that how to go forward. I remember Comrade Pansare's statements. He always, in his public speeches, he always used to give a phrase. He always used to tell a phrase. He used to say about Shatru Mitra Vivek. That was his quote, and we quote it many times. So he used to say that when you are facing such a huge and strong enemy before us, the ideology that is killing the very base, constitutional base of our country, the democratic setup of our country, and instead of looking at this enemy, if we don't have this Vivek, Shatru Mitra Vivek, then we will keep fighting among ourselves. So always he used to remind us of a line, okay, the right and the left, and all those who are from the center to left, he always used to appeal to them that they should unite, and in unitedly they should raise their voice against all these things. So I think all those who are on one side of this line, they should think about the serious danger, the serious situation that has emerged now, and this is unprecedented situation. That is what I feel. So to fight all these undemocratic and unconstitutional factors, all we have to come together on one flat platform and protest. You know, it's good that everywhere throughout India we see protest against the free voice of the killing the voice of a journalist like Gauri Lankesh. I think we go forward and may walk along one path at certain point. That is what I hope. Yeah, because there is no other alternative for us. We don't want to lose anyone else now.
Yes.
Yeah, that is really important, because though we say that they are martyrs and we remember them, the vacuum that is being created, it cannot be filled so easily.
Absolutely. Thank you very much, ma'am, and thank you very much for watching this.